install Docker in your this machine, the server you have rented, and you say run this image, your whole application will start. All the database will start, your application server will start, everything will start. So that's better, correct? You don't need to transfer application individually, database individually. You don't need to install Apache, you don't need to install PHP, you don't need to install these things on your servers, correct? So you can put them together in a container, and you transfer that container, you install Docker, only Docker on that machine, and you say run this container. That's it. So all these things will get run now. You don't need to worry about anything. And this thing, big scale, Kubernetes, Mesos, Docker Swarm, all these things, these are software you use to manage your Docker images. So suppose your application goes down, you need to restart one more. So you need to tell the guy, okay, if something goes down, restart this image again. So this is the software that will do that. So you will install Kubernetes. You will tell the Kubernetes, okay, I want minimum one instance of my application running. And this is the Docker image which you will run. So if something happens to application which is running, it will kill that application, it will take that image and run that image again. You don't need to manually do all those things again and again. So this is basically big scale, small scale, and that one only. So if you need to run like thousands of instances when you are dealing with 1 billion customers, then you need all these things. For small scale, these things, I have never used any of these things, so no need. My company uses Docker, but not very extensively. Okay, now this thing, Jenkins and all those things, this is related to development only. So you are changing some files or something, and you are using Docker, and you are hosting your thing on AWS, correct? So if you are changing some files, you need to rebuild the whole package, correct? Because some files have changed. Docker image has to be rebuilt. So these things, Jenkins, continuous testing and deployment, what this will do is, something changes, you have defined certain triggers that if this happens, then run these tasks. So it will test your application, it will build the Docker image, and it will send it to your servers, and they will start deploying the new image, correct? So the whole idea is, you are developing something, correct? It has multiple components. So now I can put it down. So this will be the last 5 minutes, and we'll bring together all these things. So you have your application here. This application contains your web server, your database server, your Redis server for caching, your search engine, maybe Elasticsearch or something. Okay, your application has 4 components. Web server deals with supplying HTML and all those things. Elasticsearch deals with searching data in your database or whatever, and stores the data whatever comes from client. This database is for long-term persistence, maybe some backup, some MySQL or something, some relational database or MongoDB. This is for caching. So this is this is not very unrealistic. This happens in a lot of applications. So you have this application. This now, for if you want to deal with a lot of people, you need to have multiple web servers running, you need to have multiple this thing running, multiple this thing, and multiple this thing. One way to do that is, you rent 10 computers in AWS, correct? You say, okay, transfer these, you manually transfer these files into 2 computers. This file, this server into 2, you install Elasticsearch in 2, you install Redis in 2, you install MongoDB in 2. 2 are remaining, that is fine, okay, 8 computers. So you transfer all these, you install all these, whatever is needed in those computers. Correct? That's what you do manually. How do you do it? It's different, but that's what DevOps people do. So they will transfer these things. Now, a better way to do is, discovered is a Docker. So Docker, what we will do? It will say, okay, package this thing,
not this thing, okay, package my web app into a container, package my database into a container. You will, all the components you will package into individual containers. What that means, your database will be installed into your local, whatever software it needs for it to run JVM or whatever, some language compiler or something, it will also install that. It will install everything what is needed to run this thing. It will take all those things, put it into a container, build a Docker image. You go to your server, you install Docker on all 8 of these, and you just transfer these images to that. That's just one thing. You just transfer this thing and say, okay, run this image. So that's containerization, which if you don't containerize it, you will need to go to each machine and install whatever is needed for that particular this thing. If JVM is needed for this database, you need to go to that computer, install JVM, install some OS, install this database, and then say run this thing. If you have a Docker image, you just install Docker, you say run this image. That image already have all those software in it. Correct? So that's a faster way to deploy your applications to handle all these things. Now, after Docker, the same thing comes like reliability and availability. There is also this term availability. So availability means if one database goes down, start another. So in older scenario, if something goes down, you will have to manually install everything again and in a new machine, correct? And you have to restart it. With Docker, you just install Docker and run it again. Correct? Okay, I am pretty sure this is not probably conceptually it's making sense to you, but until or unless you deal with it on a day-to-day basis, you don't need to really put your head into it right now. Anyway, so what I'm getting at is, you do all these things manually. So either you transfer your things without container, that you do manually, or you transfer your containers manually, or you can do some automatic things here. So these things, which I said I'll talk about later, these things are automatic. These things. So you use Ansible, Salt, Chef, Puppet. From the name itself, you can see it's something to do with making things. So these are the softwares. You install these softwares. You don't need to install now anything else, because now we are automating all these things. You install these softwares on whatever machines you want. You define tasks. Okay, when I give you, you only need to give one command. You say run everything, and you already decided what to run. So this will say, okay, I have to install Docker, I have to pull the image from web somewhere, I have to run that image, I have to detect whether something is running or not, whether if something is not running, I have to kill that machine, I have to repeat this step again. So these things, what we were doing manually earlier, these things you can automate. That's it. Everything you have to do, like even if you don't use any of these, you will have to do what these things are doing. Sometimes if you don't want to do it manually, you can use these things. If you want to like deploy without headache of installing everything all the time, you can use containers, Docker, and all those things. And this continuous testing and deployment is basically when you change something and you want to trigger the rebuild. You have your application somewhere, you are developing it, and you want to release a new version, correct? It's been 7 days. So you need to tell Ansible to start its process, correct? To pull the latest change and all those things. So what you will do, you will set up this thing here. It will keep track of everything which is happening. It will keep track of all the tasks which are happening. So you will say, hey Jenkins, new version is ready, start everything. Start build process. So Jenkins will say, okay, hey Ansible, start your own thing, start your tasks. Okay, Ansible will do, okay, first task is get the code from GitHub.
it will get the code from GitHub, it will build the Docker images, it will then test, it will run the test suite, it will then deploy to whatever applications are there, it will then delete the old containers which were running earlier, it will then change the DNS entries or whatever, it will create then auto scaling groups which will handle killing and crashing things. So all these things. So you don't need to do things manually. So whatever you are doing manually, this is just automating all those things. And when you have to do it on a scale, then these things matter a lot. When you are doing things on personal projects or like normal, simple jobs, like some startups, only some companies need this kind of application, but today this is fancy. Like it's easier, that's given. But then you don't need to know. You will do all these things manually yourself, but it will not be a headache for you because your application is not that large, it doesn't have that many components, the users are not there that many, so it will not crash that faster, you will not have pressure to restart it every time and all those things. So you will not need to think about, okay, how can I make it more robust, how can I make it more fast, how can I make it more automatic or something. So when you start to get into that area, then you will need to think about all these things. Cool? Something you want to know, like something you want me to talk about a bit more or something?
Yeah, so dialing back several notches.
Yeah.
For rank beginners, like you said,
yeah,
the vanilla version of it is what they should
focus on. Yes, yes, exactly.
Rather than anything looking at what comes next.
Yes.
So two ways right now we are going about it is the FCC has its own pre-built exercises.
Correct.
Right, which actually get you into the group.
Correct.